Okay, so carrying on from last time where I had the basic functionality registration kind of mechanism implemented for a position in physics, this time I'm going to carry on in that same vein, implement the same for flow resource, and then, because that'll remove a couple more of the items, sorry, not resource pools, although resource pools will actually have to can be removed after this point. Getting rid of the resource pools, same thing with the loaders, and that'll leave, the only thing that'll be left would be the systems after that point. But I need to get to that point. So, first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to implement the registration into flow resource right now. This is all in the root of resource. We'll just kind of add it to here, registrar. We're going to add the library if I can find it. So foe A B C D E F G M. Okay, foe simulation like that. Go into registrar. We'll also have to add it to here, registrar. CPP. So we got this. We'll go to here as a basis for what we need to do. And here, so if foe, resource registrar. Okay, copy those. Go down here, we'll need to add it to this, so just before shader loader. Star.cpp, wonderful. Got that. We need the copyright. Scrap that, scrap that. Space. Okay. Move that over. That's already as good as it needs to be. Close that up. And now we're here. So we have the two functions. We have void. Just copy these for the moment. So we only have resources here. I'm going to need these. And then I also need to include foe source. An ambulance just down there. Armature, is it? Oh, and the loaders. We also have the resource loaders to go. That's a lot of fun. Where are the. Down here, resource pools. There we go. We grab all these pools. Not those ones, that one, but these ones. Do those. And then we gotta do the same thing for these loaders. Loaders are still kind of something in flux I gotta deal with. Gotta rework them a little bit. In order to rework them well, I need to have this in place as a constraint. Okay. Okay. P simulation state. We got this. So actually, I'll just kind of, where's the physics one? There you are. Armature pool. New image pool. Cool piece animation. I should just like copy paste this for like the one left. This for new shader pool. UFO vertex descriptor pool. Okay. We'll do same thing for loader. So simulation state source loaders in place. Back. Let's copy this. Oh, arm loader. No, not mesh. We're down to shader. Oh, vertex descriptor loader. Okay. Yeah, okay. For auto MP pool simulation state, go through resource loaders. I kind of got to do this as a repeat pattern. I do this as a template, or I could do this as a template. Check sorry, not void star pool. It'll be a what? What is this? What is this? Resource. type, destroy type. Okay, if I put that one first, the other one could be derived, right? Something like that. Dynamic cast of in type for pointer. If dynamic pointer. Pointer, and then pointer is null pointer. Okay, let's try this. We destroy. Equal. And the other type is a what? On destroy, so loaders, that. Does that work? Not sure exactly why it's recompiling those. I don't remember touching them. Come on. It appears to be fine. Okay, I'll take it. So we got that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and we do the same thing down here for the other type. 4 auto p pool of p. Resource pools. Destroy. Not destroy pool, but destroy. Destroy object. Find, search and destroy. Basically, it's the same as this. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're on the pool side. Basically, it's the same as this, and this, going down to application. No, not that. This. Deregister. Yeah, this is that. There we go. We've got a real thing. We've got a bunch of component pool, two component pools, a whole bunch of resource pools. Very close together in memory. Very close to the start of memory, too. Oh, no, no, not close to the start. 608. Look like zeros almost. And come on. Resource loaders, same the match, basically. I think. All done without actually having to know what they are. Lovely. Sorry, did it actually fail? Something failed. Ah, very bad. Keep use after free. Really? On the vertex descriptor loader, search and destroy. Really? Okay, at this moment, resource loaders, we are the first one to be destroyed, correct? Yes. So if we go in, it's just dying right now. Not even... Okay, hold on. Where am I right now? Here on destroy. We're destroying the same state. I can't really tell what type it is. I presume this is the type, right? We're deleting. No, we're not. Freed by this thread, hold on. That and that is a bit of a problem. Use after free issues. So not great, not great at all. That's better. I mean, now we've got the other bug again, but hey, you know. Moving forward, bit by bit. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some logs. Very verbose logs. That's what it's called. Okay. And this is just one thing. That'll take no time at all. I'll just say, I mean, like, what does this do? This just adds and moves it. You know what? Actually, no, because there may be more going on down the line, I'd rather have a bit more verbosity here. And I'll probably do the same thing here. I really need to have the ability to really crank up a lot of logging stuff on basically everything. And since this can be compiled out very easily, especially if it's verbose messages, then I'm more than willing to have this stuff floating around. Sorry, position, right? Yes, there you are. That's always a recurring issue I find with myself is I'm always adding a lot of things. I'm saying, oh yeah, you know, I'll just add the error codes or the logging. I'll add it later when I have the system more complete. And I mostly complete the system and then I just move on. I just keep not adding it when I really should be. So I'm going to like really force myself to really start adding it in. Gotta do it right. Because I keep doing this to myself. I keep just kind of having issues and going like, oh, well. Having to really... that are registered and what have you. Okay, we move back to here. We have the stuff. Now we have to initialize. Now, initialization is a bit of a new thing. Like right here. Let's see what's going on here. These have very specific... functions for getting resource definitions, for finding external files. Asynchronized that. Plus, I'm sure, graphic session passing in the other loaders, okay. But this is just the loaders, right? This is a new thing that sits on top of position. Interesting question. If I was to remove this, how would that work? That would not work, right? Couldn't infer template argument destroy type. Okay. Can also probably go into physics, search and destroy. Oh, hold on, whoa. Ooh, yeah, that's not what I'm looking for. That's what I'm looking for. How did that pass? How on earth, like, yeah, how would that have passed? Unless it was just getting lucky every time deleting it. Because, of course, it's always going to dynamic cast, so it's just, it already knows about deleting other things right now. But the thing is, I wanted to destroy specific ones. Destroy type that. And if I was to accidentally put in the wrong one, that should completely, like, utterly fail, right? Ooh, there's not even an error for that, actually. Physics, okay. That bug. I know. Okay, physics, position, resource. Okay. Okay, let's focus on the loaders then right now. As strange as they do share the same basic thing. They have this. They load other loaders. What's this? Resource pools. So I need to have to do that. So the loader is going to have to. Which one has the most, actually? Or maybe not. If that, then we'd have. Resource pools. Then resource loaders. Then of course we have component pools. Systems like that. Then we'd also have, if I go to the declaration for this. Resource import function. So things for the resource loaders would be that. Resource definition import function. Okay, then we'd have this other one, which would be an external system function. This. is for asynchronous jobs. Synchronous job function. Actually, no, I don't even use it, don't have it. So these are the types that I can think of right now. That we need to start passing through. Okay, and then I'd have to kind of collect all these in here in the registrar function. I'd have to have like an on. What if I'm doing do I want to split up the initialization based on do I want to split based on graphics and then like the creation and then the graphics have them separate? Like what if I, okay, there are going to be cases where I'm going to create things which don't have graphics attached for whatever reason. Right. What if I'm initializing graphics after I do this? Like I'm you know what? For now, everything will be initialized together. You know, I'll deal with that odd case later. On init, so we'll have a new like on create on destroy on init. So there's a new one, takes that in. Rather, no, it wouldn't take that in, or would it? Take something, where was that? Fake struct of mine. Here you are. So we go up to here, physics. Where is it? Not physics, non-position. Non-resource, down here, in simulation. Include core, we have a new struct this. So this would have to know about full graphics. ifg. Not for anything, the heavy stuff, I do need for graphics. Okay, we've got the resource pools. So these are based on base that. So we don't have to deal with vector implementation weirdness. It's better if we just do this. Okay, create info base. Sorry, not that, ECS. ID. Where on earth did faux ID come from? I don't remember having that. Must have a random folder still hiding out somewhere. So this, why is it not? It may just be haven't updated. Let's see, make lists. Okay, everything else is going okay. Create info. I'll kind of call it that for the moment. Okay, so we have. I'm not going to do each of them separately. They're just going to be this way. Init and dinit. Okay, we'll just do this. Void constantly. Yeah. We'll have that. We'll also have to do something similar for deinitialization, but I don't think we need that. It'll be like, it'll just be these instead. Okay, let's do physics is always a nice small one to try out first. Now we'll put this here, move this over here. Close it, just clear it up a little bit. Okay. P in an info where we go through. Oh, I gotta do it this way, don't I? Resource loaders plus pinit info resource loader count. Okay. Okay, we're going to go back to this. We've got the auto star P. What is the type of the resource loader? Move this over here. Shader that. Where's the physics? There you go. Right here. Hold on. Right now it's a pointer to a pointer, so I need to do this. Right? Okay, I'll figure that out in a moment. If we'll have to do collision shape loader initialize. Info. What did I call it? Resource definition inf function. Okay. And the async function. Okay, to make this a little bit easier, we'll go down here, we'll scrap loading of the other types. So it's just physics for the moment. And then I need to have a and to add the ability here. In the core, so deregister functionality that plus an export. It's going to be having the init info. Would it have the init info? This and okay. What's in the simulation state, anyways? Because if it's just right, there's basically nothing in here. Okay, we just kind of have this. One that works on deinitialization, deinitialize simulation. Because realistically, what I actually want to do is have throw that around. I mean, realistically, I shouldn't even be throwing that around. I would just be throwing the simulation state itself around. that, and we don't need that there. Okay, we're getting some really weird jankiness going on here. Not exactly happy. While we're doing something so low level, we need to lock this. Then we need to go through P simulation state. Do I want to check if it exists or not? You know what? I will. Just to be absolutely sure. Would I have to, realistically, it should be returning. No. Does it really matter? I don't think it really does, actually. I'd want to. Okay, it doesn't really matter. Warning. We'll set it as a warning. Like, this is some very weird stuff. Otherwise, we can run it safely, because if it can't find objects that, then like it does nothing anyways. Okay, so for that, okay, back down to initialization. Then we've got to go through, it doesn't really matter if it's here or not in the states list. What really matters is I need to go through and try to call initialize. So I need to go through for anything that's still registered, that is. This is a local copy, so I can do this where p resource pool. tools equals p simulation state dot, so not that, p resource pools dot data. Is a pointer to point? Yes, that's right. It would be a pointer to pointers. You'd be correct. No, it's very strange. I'm using this even though I have them in vectors, but I'm trying to move away from using vectors specifically so I can have a bit more flexibility down the line. Simulation state dot resource loader dot size. Resource loader count. Okay, and we'd also be doing the same thing on the other way. Yeah, no, we're just sending in the, we don't have any of this stuff, we're just sending in the state right now. I mean, would we even? Yeah, no, we need to iterate through the pools there. That's true. That is true. Slowly devolving into C again. Classic. Okay, let's try this out in the application. So we create it, we do this. We have new sim state. Gonna need to actually create the info for that. We have graphics session, which is nothing right now. We have I can't do this. I can't do this at this point because I don't have group data and such. Actually, I do. They just don't do anything yet. That does exist. It does exist right now. So I can do these two. Okay. That's finding external file. That's resource, external. Okay. We can have these two. We have the async job function, which is this, which I don't have declared quite yet, right? Which I'll just kind of do this instead. Hope that's good enough. The rest of these will be blank. That's fine. I think that'll be fine. Let's see if it's fine the old-fashioned way. Okay, so what's going on here? Pointer. Yeah, no, this should be pointer. What? This is iterating through. Would this be like a pointer to the pointer? This is a pointer. Pointer to that location. To that location. No, to that. Whatever, we'll find out in a second if it actually comes to fruition. I'm not doing it yet. Dot equals, cancel that. That'll make sense. I hope. It's not loading. Why is it not loading? Load now? Yay! Okay, we're here. We're adding all this stuff. That's great. So we go inside. There is one. It should be there, and that'll take us in here. Great. We have a pointer to several deep. Come on back through with an actually incrementing iterator. Okay. Yeah, I only have loaders. Simulation state, we're going for the loaders, that's great. Search MD in it. Supposed to be a const type, and I guess. Okay. Oh. Whoops. Still allowed the no accept. What's the worst that could happen? Well, actually, the worst that could happen is I'm not calling the function anyways, so yeah. I can also, therefore, call deinitialize simulation here as well. Almost, because I got this lock here. I don't really want to have the added overhead of. Void. what's going to happen is that we're going to do this. I'm going to pass that in. Like that. And what's going to happen is instead we're going to call this. This also means I can then call it from here when I'm destroying it. Just in case. It should be safe. Yeah, and then I don't have lock contention. So then we go down to here. It's exporting it right. Yeah. I like it. I like it a lot. Let me clear these out. Last minute mistake there. Let me just kind of stage this. Not that, but this. And okay, the other. There's nothing to do for position, but there's a lot to do for resource. So let's do it. Let's add all the init, dinit stuff to this. So grab physics. Let's just kind of. Oh, yeah, I also need to do that. Search and deinitialize. Then we've got the initialization to deal with. For resource loaders. Let me, hour and 20. Let me pause here, grab a drink. Okay. And was the initialization for resources? Yes. Okay. Let's have a look at how I did it here. I had that. Going through resource loaders. Iterator pointer. Okay. We're going to want to do that in. Would we want it in this order? It doesn't have to be in any particular order. They can be initialized in whatever. So I'm just going to follow the order that they are created. So we'll start with the armature one. So. initialized. P init info for the resource definition import function. External file search and an async job. Iterator, it's a pointer, wonderful if image. Material. Okay, what does material need as well? It needs the shader loader. Right. Search type, I need a kind of function that allows me to find these things. So search type, and then input type. So we know the search type, so we got a input iterator. Equals dynamic cast of search type for start. If dynamic pointer, then return that. Otherwise, you didn't find it, return that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Resource loaders. We're looking for the faux shader loader. Call it that. Maybe search is just too generic. Expected something after template. Template, that. Search type, that. Okay. Known type input iterator. Oh! Type name. Yipe name. Ip name. Okay. Got that. We need resources. Two resource. What's this? Graphics VK. This is another not great thing. So we got that. Shader loader. Okay. Then we got. Loader. Okay, I'll just find this thing. What does he need? He needs this. I'm going to add this for the moment to this. I don't know where this is from. It's from here. Ooh, dang. It's going to bring in Vulkan as well. I'm not really. No. Okay. Where do I get this? Can I get this from elsewhere? No. Okay. Fragment descriptor pool. Surely I'm getting this from. Dang. Okay. Not entirely sure how to deal with this. Okay, it's already being brought in. No, it's private, isn't it? Okay, I need to bring it through here. Or do I? No, I don't. It is a generic type. I can just for declare it. That's something I need to work on. Completely clean break. Very unfortunate. Okay, we got that. Image loader, shader pool. Shader pool is the last one. Okay, we've got the graphics. We don't even need the graphics session. Hilariously. We do need, though, P shader loader, P shader pool, P info for frag descriptor pool. Okay, and then we got graphic session. Okay. We've got the import function, then we've got the external, then we've got the async job. Material loader, yes. Shader loader, shader pool, frag descriptor pool, image loader, image pool. Graphic session. Ah, no external function file. Okay. So what's next? Mesh. Here we go. Looking quite a bit better. Got the graphic session, then these three. Okay. What's next? Shader loader. Okay. And finally, the vertex descriptor pool. Needs a shader loader. Shader pool, I presume. And then that, we just need the definition, don't need external files. Okay. So this is a fun one. That and that. And here I also need to add like pvk equals frag. Compile that. Never happens. These, oh, because I removed them from the registrar. Nope. Just not what I'm looking for. This is here and here. Because graphics session isn't initialized yet. Okay. I'm going to move the testing this code section elsewhere down after we've initialized that. So it should be safe to do it around here. So we'll actually also add that. Maybe not. Okay, oh, right, yeah. Okay, I must have got a soft lock somewhere. Yes. So shader pool, the image. Okay, these are all real things. So I go through with it. Essentially, I hit this one. P shader loader. This is real, and this is also real. Mm-hmm. Nope. We got a problem. And the question is, why? What's going on? Where's on the initialize of simulation state for these things, right? Oh, now I deinitialize, but I'm not destroying, so that's fine. Upload context public. For this one, for full image, okay. Going into registrar. I'm coming into here. I'm here. I'm here. I'm going in after I've already deinitialized it. Okay, yes. Okay, got a little bit of a problem there. That's I'm not cleaning up properly, am I? Oopsie. There you are. We've got another one. Presumably from another one. Mesh loader, right? Right about here. Okay, that's where it was created. This is where it should be, yeah. So I'm on Faux Destroy, I'm here. So what we got going on here? We've got two of these. And pool, this is being nulled. Okay, well, at least the deinitialization is fine. So now we're at a different point. So, okay, we put these. Put that in, okay. Now back to this. Now this, I'm not entirely sure why this is happening. I really am pretty sure. Like, why? This is a dynamic cast for another. Did I not just properly destroy everything before? Auto, like. Search and destroy. These things are all being cleared out, right? I'm looking at the pool types right now. That's the wrong one. That's also the wrong one. We're not even at this point. Let's swap things around a little bit. Let's go into here. Let's, it's on position that's failing. So we do this, do these, right? Make sure that's fine. Okay, now we're going to have problems. On what? This is the bullet thing again. And the bullet thing again. Come on. Huh. I've got a very. Okay, but the point is it's reaching past this point. That's what really matters for the moment, right? Yeah, we're good to this point. Okay. Re-adding in physics. Wait, hold on. Is physics? I'm not destroying things properly. Is that it? And nullifying it afterwards. Searching D in it. Okay. It's running deinitialization. Fine. And then pLoader and pPool. These things are being, yeah, nullified correctly. Or so I would have thought. Okay, something to do with physics. Actually, no, just do the physics in isolation. That's great. That's what I want to do. And physics on destroy, go into here. Want to reference that? That actually probably would help, wouldn't it? Yeah, that's why, isn't it? Because that's switch and destroy. It's a right. Yeah. Because I was just nullifying a pointer, the local pointer, not the actual object I'm trying to. So that should mean I can re-add it right away without issue. This, we were working on those. We had double the initialization resolved. We were back to this point. Everything's initialized, everything's good. Good, 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 good. Okay. So, what would next be? Next would be. Systems. Do I really want to work on systems or just kind of. Okay, you know what? I think I'll actually call this good for today. It's been just about 2 hours. I'll go get some rest and then I will come back tomorrow and see if I can. What am I going to do next? We add it to the to-do list. What am I going to do? This is how blank my mind is right now. Running on fumes. I initialize it, deinitialize. I don't know. I really don't know. I guess I would have to just start integrating it into so that the importer and that the importers, the import functions here would actually start using it. Because I'm kind of at the wall, either that or systems, something like that, right? Whatever. Cheers.